Welcome to New Hampshire Politics with John Burt. I'm John Burt, and today I'm by myself, and what I want to talk about is the upcoming election. And geez, you know, I got the dates, hold on. I have them. I don't have a primary, and I'll tell you, it is nice not having a primary. I am running for state representative. This time I'm running in District 39, which is Goffstown, Weare, and Deering. So hopefully, you know, you'll still vote for me on September 9th is when it's coming up, is the primary. So make sure you get out there and still vote for me. And what this show is going to be about is who I'm voting for. But also, at the end of when I get done, don't, you know, turn the TV off or turn to another channel. Because I'm only going to do a short show here. And I also have a short show of two candidates. One is candidate for U.S. Congress, Frank Guinta. He's going to be airing after this. And that'll be on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, somewhere in there, Sunday. And then I'm going to have also the other half of the week to fill the spot after I get done talking today on who I'm going to vote for is Howard Coffman. And it's he's going to run in the Hillsborough Register of Deeds. And it's a good show. So let me get going. Also, in a couple minutes, I don't know if I really have an apology about Dave Pierce or just, I'm not sure, but I'm going to be talking about it. So hang in there. But first, what I want to do is, in case you do have to run, I want to run down and tell you who I'm going to vote for. And then I'll explain, you know, about Barbara Griffin, Dave Pierce, and then a few other people, you know, why I'm voting for who I am. But first, let me start, and what I'll do is I'll put the ballot up real quick at some point here while I'm talking, and then if you want, you can look at it real quick, and then I'll be talking at the same time. But the first vote that you're going to do is for governor, and I'm going to vote for Andrew Hemingway for U.S. Senate. It says vote for not more than one. I'm going to vote for Jim Rubens. Bob Smith I really like, but I'm going to explain why I'm voting for Jim Rubens. For Congress is going to be Frank Guinta. Executive Councilor, probably Burns, because I really don't know Adams, but I do know Bob Burns. For State Senate, Eileen Landies, she's not in a primary. But for state representative, Hillsborough District 6, that's what it's called, and it's just the reps in Goffstown. That's what I was this last term. Who I'm going to vote for is James, and nobody asked me to come in here and do these. So I want to make sure that's clear. You know, nobody's asked me to endorse them, anything else. This is just how John Burt of Bay Street in Goffstown is going to vote. That's it. Like I said, nobody's called me. So when I say names, you know, if for some reason you don't like me, and I hope you do, but let's say you don't take it out on the people that I talked about, because they really, you know, they don't know I'm doing this. I'm just mentioning some names that I'm going to vote for. And it's James Butcher, Rick Christie, Cal Pratt, he's our current representative. I'm probably going to vote for Claire Rouillard. I've met with her, and I really like a lot of what she said, and she's working the campaign hard. So, you know, I think she deserves a vote there. I do like Jane Sodequest, you know, but I'm probably going to go with Claire. And then also Nick Zaricki, and I hope I pronounced his name right. And those are the five that I'm going to vote for. And now for State Representative Hillsborough District 39, which is Goffstown, Weare, and Deering. There's only one name, John Burt, myself, so make sure you mark that. And then for Sheriff, you know, I'll talk a little bit about that. County Attorney is the only one name, so I'm going to vote for Dennis Hogan. There is a, for County Treasurer, there is a primary, and David Fredette, I think he's the current one for the treasurer, and yeah, I think he's doing a good job. You know, I've met him several times, seems like a pleasant guy, and I've never heard anything bad about him, so I think I'm going to go ahead and vote there. But then Register of Deeds, there's a vote for no more than one. And like I said, Howard Coffman will probably be airing after one of these shows during the week, and the other time it's going to be Frank Guinta. They're going to kind of split the week for me. But I'm going to vote for Howard Coffman on the Register of Deeds, and I'll tell you why on that. Let me think. For County Commissioner, there's just Carol Holden. And then for county delegate, or for state convention, I'm sorry, for delegates to the state convention, it says not more than five. So, you know, you really have to go to the end of the ballot to get this. And you really should vote, you know, at least for one person in every area. But it's Mark Warden who I'm going to vote for, Chris McRae, Karen McRae, Fred Plett, he's a good guy. I think he serves us very well in the Republican Party. And then Matt Simon, those are the five there. So I guess that's about it. And so let me get started on for State Representative Hillsborough District 6. There is 9 people running for 5 spots. And the reason Barbara Griffin and Dave Pierce won't get my vote, and I do want to talk about Dave real quick. I received some information from a very reliable source that he was, and I aired it on my show a week ago, or a couple weeks now, you know, that I thought he was a Democrat down in Virginia. Well, to come to find out, I guess there's like 5 Dave Pierces down there. This is what I'm hearing because I heard some grumbling about my show that I shouldn't have done that. But you know what I say? If I shouldn't have done that, anybody can come in and tape their own show. So come in and see Adam and say, I want even an hour show, half hour, come in for half hour, 20 minutes, and they'll accommodate you. You know, I really believe that's what people should do, is come in here and talk. But let's say Virginia isn't even existent anymore with Dave Pierce. So if I made a mistake by listening to a very reliable source, I do apologize for that. I believe I'm correct in the information that I received, you know, but he is saying that he's been a lifetime Republican. So let's take that on face value. So again, I do apologize if I hurt anybody's feelings for, you know, saying that he was a Democrat. So let's wipe that out. Again, I do apologize. Let's forget about Virginia. So let's focus on Dave Pierce in Goffstown. I know when he was a selectman, he couldn't spend your money fast enough and my money. He never said no. So to me, you know, that's, as a Republican, that is not what I want representing me. I want somebody that's going to go up there and look at the bills and say, is this good for Goffstown and for the state? Because I am a state representative. I have to look after the welfare of the state, you know, not just Goffstown. There are reps up there that, oh, I'm just going to vote just for my town. Well, they're not doing this town any service by doing that. And let me explain, because if I make a healthy state, Goffstown benefits from it. I do look at Goffstown when I make my decisions. That's where I get my information, is from the voters here, from you guys. You know, a lot of people call me up or send me emails and say, John, on this subject, you know, could you vote this way? Could you vote that way? And I'll look at the bill and vote what I really believe in the right way, and I get both sides. So I really thank you for doing that. But, you know, I'm just concerned with the spending that happens under, you know, the selectmen when Dave Pierce was there. Now, Barbara Griffin, there's no secret. From what I'm hearing, she was a Democrat forever, right up until May. She switches. Oh, put me down on the Republican side. Wink, wink. Nobody will notice. Yeah, well, I'm telling you, a lot of people notice, because, boy, did I get some phone calls on that one. So, and why I want to pick James Butcher is because I think he's a young, energetic guy. You know, I think he will do good for us. He believes in freedoms. He says no to any, you know, income or sales tax. You know, I think we should give him a chance to get up there. The other is Rick Christie. I've met with him many, many times, and I'll tell you, he is a hard campaigner. And again, none of these people know that I'm saying their name in here. So if for some reason you don't want to vote the way I'm going to vote, you know, look at the candidates. I want to make sure you do that, you know, because this is just how I'm voting. But with Rick Christie, you know, I think he's a true conservative. You know, I've asked him a lot of good questions, and he's definitely pro-Second Amendment, as all of these candidates pretty much are. James Butcher definitely, and Rick Christie. The other one is Cal Pratt. I've served with him for two terms. He was up there prior to me, so he is really the senior rep. He has always voted, you know, positive, you know, in my eyes, you know, with no tax, no, you know, free anti-freedom bills and et cetera. Now, Claire Rouillard, hopefully I'm saying that name right. You know, I really don't know her well, you know, but if I have to pick somebody, you know, on the fifth person, I probably would pick her. You know, she seems, you know, the time I talked with her, very delightful person. She's educated. So I think she could bring something up there. You know, she's really big on freedoms, and you know, I really enjoyed our talk that we had, and I've talked to her a few other times, you know, on the phone, and you know, I think she would do good. And then Nick Zaricki, again, he's helped a lot of campaigns. You know, he's a young guy, but I think he's a go-getter. I think he's willing to do the work. I think he's willing to be up there and serve us well. So, you know, please vote for those. And again, that's James Butcher, Rick Christie, Cal Pratt, Claire Rouillard, and Nick Zaricki for District 6 is what they call it, but it's for the five reps in Goffstown. And then, of course, District 39, like I said, is Goffstown, Weare, and Deeren. I jumped in that spot. You have to get the information out, and I'll have a more show on that. But we had five anti-gun bills. I voted and fought personally against every one of them on the House floor. I don't get up on the House floor much, but a gun bill will get me up there, especially if it's an anti-gun one. And, you know, the woman that's running against me, she used to live in Weare, and she's the Evelyn Connor, she used to be the town clerk up there, very delightful lady. But bottom line, she's a Democrat, and she voted for every one of those gun bills. I looked up the record, and she did, and I'll have more information on that. She voted for the gas tax, paint tax. Luckily, the paint tax did die. You know, so you have to choose. You know, do you want somebody like that that's going to vote against, you know, the freedoms that you have and more taxes and the expanded Medicaid that is going to be very, very difficult for us to support and afford? Or do you want somebody like me that's going to get up on the House floor? So, you know, hopefully I have your vote, and but make sure you spread the word out there because Evelyn does have a pretty big name, and for some reason people, you know, if they don't do their homework, they walk in and just look for name recognition, and that's who they're voting for. But let's jump right back at the beginning, and for governor is Andrew Hemingway. And I've met that Walt, is it Havistein? The other two, I didn't realize there was two other people running, but Walt Havistein, you know, I spoke with him a couple times. The reason I'm picking, you know, Andrew Hemingway is he believes in that we need to repeal, and I believe we need to repeal the expanded Medicaid. We have to help the truly needy on the insurance part. I'm all for that. But there's now we're getting true numbers. You know how we pass a bill, like Washington does it all the time. We don't know what's in this bill, but let's just pass it. So then they pass it. Oh, it's only going to cost us $100 million. Well, then it ends up costing us $1 billion. As your state representative, some of the true numbers I'm seeing now, instead of the 90 to 100 million that this expanded Medicaid is supposed to cost us, they're saying it could reach, you know, on the outside, probably wouldn't get there, $500 million. Where are we going to come up with that? And again, you know, we have to come up with some type of a system, you know, in healthcare to help the truly needy. But we got to get rid of this train wreck before it's too late. The federal government said they're going to pay for it. I haven't seen a dollar yet. You know how they say that. Remember, they were supposed to pay, I can't remember what the percentage is, on education. They almost pay nothing. It all falls back to local. We have no control. Oh, we got local control. But we really don't when it comes to education, because they're mandating what we're going to do. And now it's costing us a lot of money. So that's why I'm voting for Andrew Hemingway. And then plus he's a big freedom guy, you know. I think Walt is kind of, you know, establishment. You know, he worked for a big defense company, which, you know, hey, we need it. A lot of jobs. But, yeah, I think he'd be for big government. And that's what I'm hearing, you know, especially in the debates. Now, the reason I'm voting for U.S. Senate and vote not for more than one is Jim Rubens. I've talked with both Bob Smith and Jim Rubens, and the reason I'm going with Jim Rubens is with, you know, Bob Smith, to be honest, I think I'm more aligned with him. But he is pretty conservative. He's out, you know, way to the right, which I like about that. But we have to have the independent vote against Shaheen. Yeah, that's who they're running against, is Shaheen. Now, who's the other guy, the Massachusetts? Let me find him, Scott Brown. He was a great rep down in Massachusetts, but he's a terrible rep up here. Yeah, I wouldn't let my dog vote for this guy. You know, but let's get back to the two prime candidates as far as I'm concerned. There is Bob Smith, you know, great guy, but Jim Rubens is going to appeal to the independents. And in order to beat, you know, the Shaheen, which we got to get her out of there, I think Jim Rubens is the guy that can do it. So that's where my vote's going to go. Now, on representative for Congress, I'm going to vote, you know, it says vote for one. There's four names on there. Two of the people I've never heard of, you know, I don't know if they're doing anything. But it's Frank Guinta or Dan Innes is really your top running people. With Frank Guinta, you know, he's been there. You know, there's a few votes I wasn't happy with Frank, and I've talked to him, and you know, but I think he is right now the best one suited to get down there and get us working again. You know, Frank knows where, you know, the building is. He knows where the bathrooms are. You know, that's kind of a joke. And, you know, I just think that he would do very, very well down there. You know, and Dan Innes seems like a nice guy. You know, he's from UNH. That's a small concern of mine, you know, because they're big, you know, kind of establishment, you know, spend more. But the way I heard, you know, he is a pretty good conservative. But, you know, I am going to go with Frank on that. State Senate, there's no primary. It's just Eileen Landies, but make sure you mark that in. Oh, and then the executive counselor. You know, I really don't know Jim Adams. You know, I see a lot of his signs out there. So, you know, I guess you almost have to do your homework on this one. You know, try to reach out to both of them to find out. But, you know, I think I'm going to, you know, throw my vote to Bob Burns, you know, Robert Burns, only because I know him. He seems, you know, pretty conservative. And, you know, hopefully he would do as well as the executive counselor. Sheriff, I did want to talk. There is no primary, but it's Jim Hardy. You know, he makes me a little concerned about the Second Amendment. You know, I've sat in his office and talked to him about it once, and I said, now, you know, if they passed a law that was against the Second Amendment, what would you do? You know, because to me, a sheriff really protects the people from the government. That's a constitutional sheriff. And I said, now, you know, what would you do? And he says, well, you know, I'm going to, enforce any law. Yeah, that's kind of a concern to me, but, you know, bottom line, he's better than, you know, the other guy. And, oh, matter of fact, let me, Bill Barry, you know, so, you know, definitely, you know, Jim Hardy is going to get my vote. You know, I wish he would be a little better on the Second Amendment, but he definitely will, because I could only imagine where Democrat Bill Barry is on the Second Amendment. You know, I imagine he'd like to come and, you know, probably get some of our guns. But to go back to District 6, I did forget about this. I want to bring up the ballot on the for the Democrat side. And, you know, as Republicans, you got to pick the Republican ballot. On the Democrat, you're going to get the Democrat if you go in there. But if you notice, there is only three people running And Ruth Gage is your current representative. You know, we got to make sure. And again, Ruth is a wonderful lady, real nice. I always cordial to her. She was toward me. But, you know, she votes wrong in my eyes. So we need to make sure she lets go. But there's two empty spots. And, you know, why did they do that? So, as you know, from what I'm hearing, you know, the Democrats are going to write in, you know, Dave Pierce and Barbara Griffin, because really that's the side of the ticket they should be on. So make sure you don't vote for those two on the Republican side, because I think the Democrats are going to vote for them. And that's the information I'm hearing. So get back to the Republican side. The county treasurer is that David Fredette. Like I said, you know, I've met him many times. Seems like a real nice guy. I've heard nothing but positive about him. You know, so he's going to get my vote. Register of Deeds. Make sure you stay tuned, because, you know, after this show, it'll be Frank Guinta or Howard Coffman, and Howard Coffman will get my vote, because, I just like what he said. You know, I think he's a numbers guy. He said, you know, definitely he's an organizer person, that he can, you know, organize what's going on. And there is talk about bringing the office up to Goffstown. And I really think he would be a good guy to fulfill that, if that happens. You know, the three commissioners need to look at that. Now, the county commissioner, says vote for no more than one. It's only one person. So apparently nobody's going to primary Carol Holden. So she's, won that seat. But, you know, make sure you go far enough and vote for her so she knows she has plenty of support. And then for the delegates, you know, like I said, the people, you know, that this is at the GOP, the New Hampshire GOP conventions. And they have a couple conventions a year have the platform. Just to set the stage, talk about current elections, you know, who they're going to support after the primary, you know, how we get people through and et cetera. And the names I'm going to vote for is Mark Warden. He's on the top. Chris McRae, I think he would do very well for us. Karen McRae, she's, you know, very delightful woman. I think she could do very well. Fred Plett, I just can't speak highly enough. Fred, he has served us very well, you know, as a Republican. And then Matt Simon, I think he would do very well. And pretty much that's it. So hopefully this will help you. I know I'm very flattered when all the emails I received and a few phone calls for people that do say they watch this and they really like that I do this. And again, it's only the way I'm going to vote. And the majority of the people that call me and talk to me about this or email me, they said why we like it is it's a starting point. So you don't have to vote every way that I am, but it gives you a thinking what I'm thinking, you know, as your representative, because I am in the thick of it. And it just gives you a starting point. And so when you say, okay, Andrew Hemingway, start there and then look at the other candidates. And if you think that I'm right, then definitely vote for Andrew Hemingway, and same way with the other votes that I pointed out. And so I really enjoy doing the show. And remember, stay tuned, because, you know, Frank Guinta is going to be coming right up after this. And then also halfway through the week, I'm going to switch it over to Howard Coffman, Hillsborough Register of Deeds. So until next week, I'll talk to you later, and I enjoy doing the show. Thank you for all your comments. Bye now.